Robert probably started to appear not long after I started school. I was quite quiet. I didn't talk to people. I often felt left out of things, kind of felt lost, not knowing where to go, who to talk to, what to say. Robert was something I created to kind of fill in that gap. He was kind of the exact friend I needed at the time, because he could be whatever I wanted him to be, because he was my imaginary friend. He was there on the school field, in the kitchen. He was just there when other people weren't. Of course, Robert eventually faded and sort of forgot about him. He became that embarrassing thing that I kind of wanted to forget. But I think if I look back on it, the idea kind of stuck. The idea of talking to someone was still there. People, they talk about their voice in their head or an inner monologue. I think, well, what if that was your imaginary friend? What if it was Robert? Even today I'll talk to myself as if someone else is there. Not delusional, I promise. Usually when I'm anxious, when I'm bored, I think in some ways it can be comforting, to think that he's still there and I can still talk to him. I've had trouble with anxiety and sort of being awkward in general. I'd be talking to myself in my head, and a part of me wants to believe that that was Robert. He was still there. Still, I've grown up, I have real friends, a real life, but when it gets bad, I know that there's still something, a part of my younger self, and that part of me, I can still count on it if I'm sad.